We're whispering about, you know, sure, it's cool to be on a big hit show on OWN, but it's also great to be a Broadway veteran. Merle Dandridge, we've seen her in Rent and Jesus Christ Superstar. You're going back to Broadway?
I'm going back to Broadway, yeah, for the hiatus, squeezing a little Broadway show once on this island, playing Papa Gay, the first time a woman's done that.
Oh, wow.
I'm excited, yeah.
What is it? Is there something distinct about Broadway that distinguishes it from any other gathering of venues in the world?
Well, the community is amazing. I love being a part of that tribe. And you either can do it or you can't.
No,
you have to have the skills.
Right, precisely.
You know, you really
you
have
can't
to train.
Fake it on a Broadway stage.
Absolutely not. And then do it 8 shows a week?
Right.
No,
no.
Absolutely not.
So is it almost an athletic endeavor to a degree?
I would say, yeah, you have to keep your health up like an athlete. Mm-hmm. 100%, yeah.
And then for vocalizing, we've had people do this before. Do you do the blah, blah, I can't even
I do all of them.
All right.
I have a million of them.
What's your favorite one?
I'll do scales and things to warm up the voice, cool down the voice.
Yeah. Is it a grind, though? Do you feel, for the 8 shows in a week or however many you do, does it feel like that?
It does, but every show is so different, and every audience brings a new energy, and it's just a delight to get out there every time and play, and you're with a really talented group of people.
Yeah. Speaking of a really talented group of people, this Greenleaf has gotten a lot of attention with very good reason.
Baby, let me tell you.
Okay, you please.
Let me tell you. I mean, the fact that I get to be in the trenches with these icons, these titans, I learn something every single day, and most of them are from the theater as well. So while a lot of them have been in front of the camera for a long time, and I'm still learning the ropes a little bit, I can pick up all the tools and the tricks, and they really look out for me. They're amazing, and it's a big learning experience.
Prior to your involvement in the show, had you ever been in a mega church or had that kind of experience?
Yeah. Well, you know, I grew up in the church. The Dandridges are steeped in the Memphis church, and that's been a part of my upbringing, being in a pew every Sunday. So it's kind of neat when your calling in life and your faith intersect, you're able to do both of those things that mean a lot to you.
As a parishioner, did you ever think, oh, there must be drama behind the scenes? Or not like this?
Well, I think one speculates here or there, but the thing about the institution of the church is that it's made up of human beings, you know, and what we like to talk about is the interesting human aspect of the institution, in any institution, and also the very human dynamics within a family. Mm-hmm. And that's what I think we really pride ourselves on, is that these nuanced relationships, you can see them in yourselves and in your own home, and I think that's one of the things that draw people into it.
Ask her about her foxy love interest, Rick Fox.
Yeah.
He is Rick Mr. Fox. Handsome. It is too much, isn't it?
Oh, he does all right for himself. He does all right. No, he's a person that comes from the background that he comes from,
is a performer.
As a tap dancer that he is. No, I'm kidding.
No.
A three-time NBA champ, you don't get to that place in your life without a great work ethic, and he brings that to our show. Mm-hmm. So we're very lucky to have
him. We're going to look at a clip right now where you reunite with your parents.
Yes. This is one of my favorite scenes from the entire series, and I think it'll bring a lot of catharsis for the characters and also to the people who are following the characters.
Watch this. Take a look.
Oh. Where's Sophia?
We left her home. We didn't know how you would look.
I know you misread my natural reserve as judgment, so I'm gonna be clear. I am so relieved that you're alive, and I don't blame you.
Wow.
Oh,
real Keith David and Lynn Whitfield there. Boy, very goosebumpy here. We should tell you that Greenleaf returns with a 2-night premiere. It's tonight and tomorrow night, 10 o'clock on OWN. Merle, really nice to see you.
You're emotional watching that.
I know. It was so meaningful. Thank you for showing that clip. I can't wait for you guys to see the episode tonight.
Terrific. Thanks so much.
Thanks for having me, you guys.
Absolutely.
Pleasure. Thank you. They are young.